A very good morning to all the children of class 9th, online children as well as offline children. So many children are attending classes. That's a good sign, but you have to follow the instructions. You have to maintain social distancing, wear mask, keep your sanitizer with you. Fine, that is important. So we're going to start new chapter, packing. Before we start, by the time you were joining, I have just written the names of characters in order of importance. The more important the character is, the topmost priority character is getting here on the board. Okay, all are important. I'm not saying others are less important, but in the role of the particular character in the chapter package. Fine. Before we start the chapter, you should know that where does it come from? This chapter packing is actually an extract. What is it? Extract.
It is taken from a book. Three men in boat. Three men in a boat. This is the name of the book.
Fine. Three men in a boat. And writer of that book is this person, Jerome K. Jerome, narrator. Clear? So this chapter packing is an extract from this book, Three Men in a Boat. Firstly, let me tell you, what is Three Men in a Boat about? It is actually the description of a journey, fine, undertaken by three friends, Jerome, Harris, and George. These are three best friends. So this group of friends, they want to go on a voyage, on a water voyage, I must say. Fine? And that's why they're going to travel through a boat. And it is mentioned in the beginning of the book, Three Men in a Boat, they have mentioned that how they decided, how they had idea of traveling through the boat and the water voyage and all. And then after that comes how they pack the things, fine? So now here I will be stopping. You will be telling me, if you imagine yourself, you want to go on a voyage and it's a long journey. You want to go on a journey, it's fine. It's a time-consuming journey. And definitely you would have to pack many things with you, fine? So now online children, you can raise your hand. I'll unmute you. Offline children, I'll be just smuggled. What is the most important thing one should carry? Or when you pack your bags, you're going on a journey for so many days. First thing you pack is clothes, fine, clothing. So Magan says clothes, very important. Yes, raise your hand, online children also, you can participate. Yes, Jatin. Blankets, if it is. Yes, Gia. Food, very good. First aid box. One by one, beta, not like this. Online children not participating. Risham. Yes, Riyanshika, right. You can raise your hand, I'll unmute you. You can speak. Water bottle, what else? It should be a sensible answer, firstly. Yes, fine. What do you say? Snacks, food, gadgets. How many things are there? Map also to locate the place. Map. Food and drinks, it is already, understood. Yes. That's it. So most of the children, they are saying that clothes, blankets, food, first aid box. Fine. Obviously, these are the basic things. What about the footwear? Fine. Shoes. Or footwear, you can say. Yeah, these are the basic things and n number of things are required. Map is required or fine. A list is quite long. So the chapter packing, the name itself tells that writer, the narrator Jerome ke Jerome,
Harris and George. They, you know, they are going somewhere and they want to pack their bags. And they think that, and everybody of us, we think that packing is an easy task. It's very easy. It's not everybody's cup of tea actually. Because when you pack the things, you have to be very, very careful about the packing. How? Heavy things come first or the light things to be put at the base? Just raise your hand. Just raise. Yes, Harry. Heavy things at the? And the things which are lighter in weight, they will be kept at the top. Right? And suppose you're packing the food. You have tomatoes. You have bread. You have eggs. Fine. And you have fruits. How you will pack? Just raise your hand. Yes, Unaisa. In a box so that nobody, you know, on the way, it might be smashed. Fine. So this is our way. Yes, eggs on the top, but we have to pack it very carefully. So I am telling you, packing is an art in itself. One should be smart enough to pack. If you do not pack smartly, you will end up when you will open your luggage, everything will be smashed and you won't be able to use it. Even your clothing will get stained and all. Fine. So this chapter packing, in which all the three friends, they are struggling to pack their bag. That's why the name of the chapter is packing. Okay. Now I'm not going to talk about three men in a boat. I'm going to talk about just packing. That was the introduction. Is it clear? Fine. So, characters. The very important character is the writer. He himself is present in this book. Jerome. You will be writing just Jerome. That is okay. Fine. His full name is Jerome K. Jerome. But you can use the name Jerome. Then we have Harris. Harris, you remember, H for Harris, H for humorous. Humorous means funny. I'm just giving you a way to remember this character. Harris is quite funny character in this. You know, who likes to have laugh. You know, in that way, his character is that. Then we have George, another character. Harris is going to create a lot of chaos. Chaos means disorder. So you have to learn new words also side by side. Fine. Chaos. Chaos means disorder.
Clear? So they are going to create chaos while packing the bag. This is to be seen in this chapter. Firstly, Jerome wants, he does not want to pack actually. But he wants to supervise Harris and George. Narrator thinks that he is the smartest of all. He already knows the art of packing. But he wants his friends Harris and George to learn from him. And he will just supervise. He wants to be the supervisor. That I'll be telling you, okay, Harris, do this. Okay, George, do that. In that way. But Harris and George are also smart. They are not doing this. So when Jerome offers his help, he says, I know the art of packing. Let me tell you. Then they say, you can also pack. You know the art very well. So Jerome gets irritated, but he was left with no choice. Fine. So what he does, he starts packing. So who starts the packing first? Narrator. When, and the process of packing is there in the chapter. How he will be packing and again unpacking, he will be forgetting many things. Okay, I forgot to put my brush inside. Brush is also very compulsory. Fine. Much needed thing. So he thought, okay. Then again, he thought, okay, my shoes are left. Then he was not able to find the brush. Brush was inside one of the shoes. So chaos and clumsiness will be seen. What is clumsiness? What is clumsiness? Anybody can tell me? If I say, narrator, Harris and George all are clumsy. Disorganized. Fine, in a very shabby way. When you, some people, if you get the food on your plate and everything is piled up, rice, uske upar aapki mama aapko aise raita dal ke de rahi hai, and vegetable on the other hand, and dessert also on the top of it like a cake. This is clumsy. But when you get a proper organized plate, dessert on one side and one, then a bowl of rice and one chapati in very beautiful way. That is organized manner of getting the things, fine. So clumsiness. So basically clumsiness will be seen in this chapter, that how all the characters will be creating chaos. They will be clumsy in packing. And fourth character, very, it's written at the last, but very cute character, Montmorency Top. He's also, you know, he was observing all the friends packing the things. And he will sit up when jam will be there. It will be like many things will be smashed in the process. Tomatoes will be smashed and jam will be squattered here and there. And Montmorency will be adding up more into the clumsiness. He will be putting his foot into the jam. He will be sitting upon the things and he will be creating more cures. So the kind of honor you have, the kind of dog will follow that. Dogs are very, you know, they follow the human instructions. Whatever you do, if they can be trained in a very easy manner. So dog is also clumsy because its owners all are clumsy. That's why this is a funny, actually, chapter, very humorous way. Clear? The basic introduction is clear. Any doubt to anyone about the characters? Yes, online children, send me your feedback, beta. I'm going to start the reading of the chapter. Send me a thumbs up for the feedback. George is also one of the friends of all three. But he's going to play very less important role. He will be speaking up at the end of the chapter only, okay? When they will be packing everything, they will start in the morning, they will end up at 12:50 at night. Fine? Near about 10 minutes to 1 will be left. And then they will end up with the packing. And then George will ask them, okay, this is too much now. We have to sleep because we have to go in the morning. We have to start early. So then George will be asking Jerome, at what time I'll wake you up? Jerome says at 6, because he's a bit responsible, better than the others. Harris is, you know, casual. George asks Harris, kitne baje uthaun? As usual, aise log jaldi nahi uthte hain. He says 7. Then they start again argumenting and they end up at 6:30. Fine, they say, okay, let it be 6:30. So you wake up us at 6:30 a.m. So George takes the charge of that. Wahan pe story aapki finish ho jayegi. Aage bahut sari hai, that is in three men and boat, not here. Okay, let's start the reading. Page number 82. Before you read, do you like going on trips? You like going on trips?
Yes.
And what kind of trips do you enjoy most? Some people like road trips. Some people like water voyage. Some people like fine in that way, in the lap of nature. So different places, different ways and different means of transportation people prefer. How do you feel about having to pack for a trip? How many of you would like to pack your bag on your own? I would also like to pack my bag on my own because we know better what we need. Fine. Maybe you can smash the things. Okay. Have you ever discovered on a trip that you have forgotten to pack a few things? It happens. It happens. We forget the most important thing. Sometimes charger is left. Oh my God. Phone rakhi hai, bahut important hai. Charger, we forget easily. Fine. So this is the thing. Does this make you angry or does it make you laugh at yourself? You become angry? Obviously, nobody is going to laugh. You become angry only. Then we have, let's read the description, how author and his friends pack. Fine. Now I'm going to read the chapter and I can ask any one of you online or offline. Online children, show me your books. Jaldi se jo online baithe hain, video on karke apna book dikhao mere ko, if you are having it. That will be a proof that you are attending the class. Yes, Gagandeep Singh, very good. He's the first one to show the book. Beta, don't waste time, jaldi se. Because I know there are children who will come to me, ma'am, mere marks nahi aaye. They do not attend the classes. Harmeet Kaur, very good. Jaldi say, there are children sitting in the class also. Prachi Aroda, very good. Show the book. What about others? Kathy, Bhavan, Soumya, Arnav, Suri, Riyanshika, Lisa, Aryan, Raghav, Arshita, Titiksha. Yes, Lisa is there, Riyanshika is there, Prachi is there, fine. So most of you are having the books, that's very good. But many children, they have not shown any book to me. It means they have just attended the class for the sake of attending. That will be your loss, Peter. So let's start. I said I would pack. Now, why did I say I would pack? I had packed you. No, I'm saying, how would you know that? How would you know that? That I will be speaking it had or as good. Anybody can give the answer to that? I'm not saying that, beta. I'm saying, how would you know that? How to speak? See, my question is, when it is written I apostrophe D, aapko kaise pata lagega that we are going to pronounce it as good or had? Kya dekhoge? After this. If it is in first form, very good, Prajesh, you got it. If it is in first form, after D, first form is there, then it means I would pack. If it is packed, it means I had packed. Got it? So, I said I would pack. I rather pride myself on my packing. Packing is one of those many things that I feel I know more about than any other person living. So this is the dialogue of Jerome K. Jerome, who is the narrator of the story. He's saying that I feel proud on myself that I know the art of packing. And packing is one of those many things that I feel I know more about other people. Fine? That he is actually self-praising. He's saying ki I know better than others. It surprises me myself sometimes how many such things there are. I impressed the fact upon George and Harris and told them that they had better leave the whole matter entirely to me. So he's telling us that even he has offered his help to his friends Harris and George, and I have asked them to leave everything on me, that I will pack, you need not bother. They fell into the suggestion with a readiness that had something uncanny about it. Underline this word. Meaning is given, but learn it right now. Uncanny means very strange, weird. आप किसी को अपनी ऐसे कई बार हम कह देते ना, ओके मैं आपकी हेल्प कर दूं, सामने वाला कहता नहीं नहीं कोई बात नहीं, I'll do it. और अगर आप बोलो मैं आपकी हेल्प कर दूं, सारा काम उसका पड़ा हो, वो कहा हाँ हाँ तू कर दे मेरा काम, ये ले. How will you feel? Though you offered the help, but you never expected ki aapko sara kaam hi pakda de. In that way, he offered his help and Harris and George, they said, okay, fine, you do it. Go ahead. And he's saying, I suggested that I will help and they became so easily agreed. There is something uncanny about it, something weird. George spread himself over the easy chair. Ye bolne ke baad, जॉर्ज का करेक्टर आप जानना चाहते थे, जबकि जॉर्ज आराम से चेयर पे बैठ, ही सेज ओके यू डू दैट शोज दैट ही इज आल्सो लेजी. इट इज नॉट नाउ बेटा, थिंग्स आर नॉट मेंशनड इन द चैप्टर बट दे आर प्रेजेंट. समझ में आ गया चैप्टर को कैसे पढ़ना? जॉर्ज सीम्स टू बी लेजी. And Harris cocked his legs on the table. Cocked his leg, when you cross your legs and you sit. Aram Singh, cross-legged, he sat on the table. Second paragraph. This was hardly when I intended. What I had meant, of course, was that I should boss the job. Boss the job means supervise the job. And that Harris and Josh should potter about under my directions. Underline the word potter about. Learn the meaning right now. Samne likha hua hai. Do some unimportant things. Yes, boys. I am doing my job. Are you doing your job
as a student, as a studious, responsible student? My question is that. Don't think teachers are fools here. This was hardly what I intended. What I had meant, of course, was that I should boss the job. So he was expecting that he will supervise the job, but his friends will do the work for him. And I'm pushing them aside every now and then with, oh, you here, let me do it. There you are, simple enough. Really teaching them, as you might say. They are taking it in the way they did irritated me. So this is irritating the author, narrator, Jerome K. Jerome a lot, that how his friends are not doing anything and they are letting him do everything, okay? Then there is nothing does irritate me more than seeing other people sitting about doing nothing when I'm working. And he says, I get so irritated when I see that I am working, but people are sitting around me free, idle, doing nothing. Fine. Third paragraph. I lived with a man once who used to make me mad that way. Now he's telling an incident of past. Jerome, the narrator, is sharing one of the incidents with us, that in the past he would live with a man. He would loll on the sofa and watch me doing things by the hour together. Means, when you lay down on the sofa, fine. So that's why he's saying he would loll on the sofa. So he, that man, he's not talking about Harris, he's not talking about George. He's talking about a strange person that in the past he would know that person would lie on the sofa and he would do everything and he would just watch over him. He said it did him real good to look on at me messing about. And not only that person would say that I love to see you creating a mess. Ek to kaam karta tha Jerome, and he would get the comment that you are messing up the things. Now I'm not like that. I can't sit still, see another man slaving and working. I want to get up and super intent and walk around with my hands in my pockets and tell him what to do. It is my energetic nature. I can't help it. So this is the trait of Jerome K. Jerome. Now you tell me, what do you learn about Jerome? What do you think? I give you options. Jerome is authoritative. Jerome is humble. Jerome is irritating personality. All of the above. Dhyan se soch ke batao. All of the above. How do you prove that he is humble? I'm saying he is irritating personality. Wo irritating hi rehta hai har time. Think. He's authoritative. Authoritative means he wants to superintend everyone, supervise everything, lead everyone, and he doesn't want to do on his own. Though he's doing it, that is a situation which is making him do. That doesn't make him humble. Wo irritate hota hai. Yes, Riyanshika, he wants to be a leader. So option A is correct here. This is one self-made question, okay? This is not where I'm just making to check that whether you're listening or not. So he wants to put his hand in the pockets and he wants to supervise. He does not want to do anything. It is my energetic nature. I can't help it. However, I didn't say anything, but started the packing. So he started the packing. Who started the packing? Who started the packing? Jerome started the packing. Brijesh, you're not concentrating now. It seemed a longer job than I had thought it was going to be. But I got the bag finished at last. And I sat on it and strapped it. After finishing the packing for the first time, we shuruaat hui hai. Sometimes, you know, you're not able to
zip it. So what do? They sit on it sometimes back ke upar baith baith ke log usko try karte hain so that everything fits in. So after putting everything, he tries to sit on it and he straps it finally. Ain't you going to put the boats in? Ain't means aren't, are not, ain't. Harris kehta hai, aren't you going to put the boats in? Boats kisne dalne hai bag mein? You forgot. And I looked around and I found, oh God, I had forgotten them. That's just like Harris. He couldn't have said the word until I had got. Now got it? Ab main yahan pe had bol rahi hu. I had got the bag shut and strapped the boots. Kehta hai Harris, ye aisa to kar sakta. If he had already seen the boots, why didn't he tell me earlier? Wo wait kar raha tha, jab ye pack kar lega na, tab main isko irritate karu. Then I will tell him that you forgotten the boots. And George laughed, one of those irritating, senseless laughs of his. They do make me so wild. George Badke, he's just making fun of this thing that, oh my God, you forgot the boots. Ha ha ha. That. So they are actually enjoying this thing, and all the work is being done by Jerome. Well, is it? Yes. Okay, beta, I'm going to end the meeting. Have a nice day.